You might have seen on our Instagram that we have something cooking, bucket list, travel gear, apparel, and all sorts of goodness. But we're gonna talk about that at the end.
Good morning from Hawaii.
Do-do-do-do-do. Where's your nuke? Show him 2 seconds.
No, that's for another time. This is 100% for my personal memories, our family personal memories. And we don't have a lot of footage of it, but I insist need to talk about this and to share this story.
What is it?
In our last video, we showed clips of our traveling back from Bhutan. Gary doesn't want to talk about this, which is understandable, but this is a story for the books.
Are you that confident in our marriage that you want to talk about this?
Our marriage almost ended.
Is why.
Okay, so travel days aren't all plain kisses and happy children. Usually we have really solid travel days. This was not one of them. It started off great. We had a 25-hour flight time coming back from Bhutan. And it started off wonderfully. We flew from Bhutan to India, India to Bangkok, Bangkok to Beijing. We're in Beijing and we had, I don't know, like an 8-hour layover and we had a 3 p.m. flight. And so I'm like, okay, like we're kicking it. I'm planning on this 3 p.m. flight that I was ready for. Garrett has the kids out at a little park and I look at the boarding pass and it says 11:30 a.m. boarding time.
What time was it when you looked
at that? It was 1:30 p.m. We were about to board for our 3 p.m. flight. There is a 3 p.m. flight, but somehow, unbeknownst to me, I booked the earlier flight. Okay, and Garrett is always like, double check, double check, double check. And I did double check, but I double checked against an incorrect itinerary. So, still my fault, I'll take the blame, my fault. So here we are in Beijing, we missed our flight. But there is another flight to LA from Beijing at 3 p.m. So I go run over to a desk at the business lounge.
Wait. You didn't just run over. She comes to the playground and is like, Garrett, watch the kids. We missed our flight. And then just sprints off. We're in Beijing and I was just like, wait, what?
Huh? Okay. So it's gonna be about 10 times easier for me to blitz around and fix things than for Garrett and the kids to
do it together.
And it's a big airport. So I'm blitzing like
mad woman.
Dear Beijing airport, why is there not an Air China desk in the terminal? Why? Okay, no, you have to leave the terminal, but to leave the terminal, you have to get a visa. And I had an hour and a half to change this flight. Didn't happen.
So we had to leave the terminal, but to leave the terminal, you have to have a visa, and you got to go through security to get back into the terminal. And once she was out there, she went to the gate, and they said you need to be together as a family. So then she gets us, and we all have to go out there, but we first all have to get visas.
And then we all have to go back through security. It was an absolute
mess. We didn't even make the 3 p.m. flight.
Yeah, of course we didn't make the 3 p.m. flight. And I'm literally yelling at people. Not yelling at people, just talking loud like a crazy American. And I'm totally like, why doesn't anybody speak English? You know, like a horrible, like, close-minded tourist.
Wait. What's the difference between yelling and talking very loud?
I wasn't, like, mad at someone. I was like, who can help me? Where do I go? So we get on this flight at 9 p.m., which is a very full flight. And I have Callie, and Garrett has Dorothy and Manila, like, on a row together. Dorothy lays down on the floor. Don't judge us. It's how we travel. Okay. And we're sleeping, just ready to, you know, 12 hours. And about 2 hours into the flight, I look up.
2 hours into a 12-hour flight.
I look up and Garrett's like moving stuff around with this like angry face. I'm like, what's going on? And
what's my angry face look like?
He's angry. I don't know. And Manila peed on Garrett 2 hours into this flight. And I'm like, oh, I'm so sorry. Like, and if you know anything about Garrett G, he hates poop, pee, throw up, any bodily function.
As opposed to love it, like.
No, like, you deal with it. Kids pee, kids poop. Like, it sucks, but you get it. No, Garrett hates it, but.
Wait, oh, okay, all the feelings are coming back. I'm pissed. Manila doesn't pee his pants. Nobody in our family has ever wet themselves on a flight. None of the kids or the adults. And so this was so out of the ordinary for this to happen. And I was just like, are you kidding me? Of all days, of all flights, it happened on the flight that we missed, 2 hours into a 12-hour flight. Stay calm, took off his pants, wrapped him in an airplane blanket. I had no change of clothes, and I'm like, there's no way I can survive. I just need to go back to sleep and wake up when this is all over. So I go back to sleep, lay my son in the airplane blanket back on me, and go back to sleep.
And Manila pees again.
Manila peed a second time. When I woke up wet a second time.
And I felt awful. And I was, in my mind, I was like, I wonder when Garrett's gonna be ready to laugh about this. It's for
not yet.
Sure not now.
Not yet.
It's for sure not 2 weeks later.
So, in my mind, I'm like, he already peed on one blanket. What do I do now? Do I divorce my family? Because that's the only solution. I am, oh my gosh.
He's ready to walk away from the whole family.
Goodbye, everyone. So I wrap up Manila in a second airplane blanket. I sit him up and I say, do not move the rest of this flight. And he sat up like, I'm such a dead man. And I remember looking over and like I lay back down and the flight attendant comes over because she sees Manila just like fear in the face and is like, are you okay? Do you need anything? Can I get you a snack? And he's like this, go away. I'm in big trouble. And he was.
It was walking on eggshells for the rest of that flight. Anyways, or for the rest of like the next flight to Hawaii.
If anyone's curious, pee after a few hours, it starts to sting the skin and smell real bad. And it just so happened, I was so mad. And it just so happened, as soon as we got off the flight there in LAX, like three people come, hey Garrett, how's it going? How much of it? Can I get a picture with you? And I was like, I smell like pee, man. Oh man. So, what's the moral of that story? Huh?
Triple check your flights with the tickets, not like the itinerary that you've like written down from the website. My fault. I'm so sorry. Please forgive me.
I did, but now I've got all those raging feelings again.
We should have saved that story for last.
Why?
Because now you're in a funk.
It's true. Wait, let's get all the funk out of our system. So, quick little side story. We went to LA for a day this week to shoot a commercial. We can't tell you for what or for who, but it was awesome. And maybe the weirdest and coolest part of it was just a little commercial, but they treated it like this big production. You would have thought a movie was being shot with all like the semi-trucks full of equipment and the lighting and all the crew and everything. And just regular us in front of the camera. But we got sick. We're not sure if it was
Speaking of the food or a restaurant or something.
We got so sick the night before our flight. We had a like 6 a.m. flight. And the night before, we're in an Airbnb. Everyone just throwing up. I would rather die than throw up. And I did. I was standing over the toilet like, don't throw up, don't throw up. Boom, I fainted. I woke up on the cold bathroom floor just like, where am I? Did I throw up? Jess, help!
And we couldn't miss our flight the next morning, so we're like, what are we gonna do? Like,
oh my gosh. So, our kids are regular kids. They whine, they get tired, they cry, but I will say this. They are super children when it comes to the hard times, because there they are on the bus from the rental car station to the airport. Each of them just feeling so tired, cold, and sick, and holding a paper cup in case they throw up. And oh my gosh, they're just looking miserable. And I'm like, guys, you okay? And they're just like champs.
Caring all,
crazy that we traveled for 3 years full time, over 300 flights, and we didn't have this craziness.
Never.
And now all this happens.
Yeah.
What's that all about? That's either the universe telling us, look, you're done, like stop traveling. Or it's saying, hey, you were better as a full time traveling.
You're better on the road. Your leg's a mess.
Anyways, ups and downs of life, ups and downs.
Oh, one more down to share. Dorothy was complaining about a tooth a few days ago, and I just thought, you know, maybe it was like getting wiggly or something. And then the next day at school, her teacher called because she was crying. She was in so much pain, and her tooth had turned gray. So I take her into the dentist. Dentist does an x-ray. Yep. It needs to come out. So Dorothy had to go get a tooth pulled.
Well, what are we doing, Dee Dee, today?
Taking out my tooth.
Taking out your tooth? Which one? Can you show me? Yeah, that one right there. Yep. Does it hurt? Not so bad right now, but it's been bugging you? Dorothy has what looks like a dead tooth, and we're at the oral surgeon getting it taken out. I bet the tooth fairy comes tonight.
Yeah.
What are you gonna buy with your money? You gotta think of something. You're a brave girl. You're gonna do so good.
Called topical anesthetic. It's like a little gum tissue next to the tooth.
What a terrible week. It didn't feel like a terrible week, but geez. There was one shiny moment. Dorothy's last soccer game. I've spent all season long just trying to not pressure her in any way and just kind of take that backseat support from
you've
the sideline.
You've done really good, because that's not
and
easy.
Get, no, put no pressure on her, because I know mine and her relationship that I understand that she wants to like make me proud, and I just don't want that pressure on her. And so I just want her to know I'm proud of her no matter what. And then it was her last game, and I think it was you, not to point fingers, but I think you said, Dorothy, go try to score a goal. And Dorothy, like, loves defense.
She's been all about the defense and been killing it. As soon as someone on the other team gets the ball, she blitzes back.
Right, and that's, like, been her thing. And then Jessica says, go try to score a goal. And I think she, like, didn't hear, so I just maybe repeated it. But when she heard the words come out of Dad's mouth, go try to score a goal, her whole countenance changed, and she just went all out. And I could tell she was starting to get emotional because the goal wasn't coming easy, and she was about to cry. So in the next timeout, I like called her over and was like, what's up? She's like breathing so hard, and she's just like, I don't think I can do it. I'm trying so hard, I'm trying to score a goal. And I was like, don't worry about it, just go out there and have fun. She's like, but you said try to score a goal. And I was like, oh no, the last game I failed. And I was like, no, forget it. But she didn't.
Right place at the perfect time. The ball crosses to her. She slide tackles it
in. She slid. Last second, slid and kicked it in.
And jumps up, looks straight at us. Biggest smile.
Oh, we just went nuts. Oh, her smile. And then she ran over and gave you the biggest hug. Yeah. Such a beautiful moment.
I cried.
We all did.
Tell me what you eat and tell me.
Okay. You guys ready?
Imo iya na wane iya.
Hei, ala no a dia eka.
Okay, next week's gonna be really great.
It's gonna be better.
It's Thanksgiving.
And no one's getting peed on. Unless I pee on you.
You.
Not over it.
You need to just build a bridge.
I do love you. And I forgive you.
Really?
Yeah.
I love you too. I'm so sorry. In my mind, the whole day, and even now, I still keep remembering sitting for those like 8 hours, like just so ready. Like we were killing that travel day. I feel like I can turn back time and like fix it.
Nope, not how it works, babe.
I've been working on something so hard and very, very big. Like I am so excited about it. It was my little like brainchild and I've been working my tail off for this.
Each year for Christmas, we do a special service project and it seems to just get bigger and better each year. But this year, you've outdone yourself.
I've outdone myself. I don't think I'm gonna be able to top it next year.
You should take next year off. No service. All there.
All you. So
get ready.
Stay tuned for what's coming up. But we do have a really cool collaboration to announce it. And that's someone we met with in Los Angeles.
Just show the picture for a little bit and then we'll get to it later.
Okay.
And just don't say too much. Just a little bit of tease. Give them just a little bit.
We've been working our tails off, if you can't tell. We did Bucket List Friends. I've got something super special for Christmas and something extra, extra cool.
All right, we'll just give them a little sneak peek. The goodness. Minimalistic Travel Essentials. Coming your way.
Soon.
Right.
Very soon.
December 4th. December 3rd, if you're a member of Bucket List Friends. Mark your calendars. It's coming for you. Okay, that's all. See ya.
Bye.
Get ready, you hold it. Is it still going?